Any other from Quincy High School representing Priscilla Brown at her second game. Creative basketball was a fundraising event in basketball game created by Quincy and the other game to support the 2021 graduation of Priscilla Brown. Priscilla has been bravely fighting brain cancer for 2 years. She was a preschool athlete at her high school, playing volleyball, basketball, and softball. If you guys want to look at that hammer, the screen is over there with the green light, you have to be okay. But somebody is watching at home from the live stream, but she can't be here today. Let's give our guys a wave and a round of applause. And before we get going, some of those sound maps, I just want to hand over the mic to a friend of the family, Ali Scarlett. Let's hear it again for Ali.
Here today and taking time out of your lives to support a person so close to so many people. While Priscilla couldn't be here in person, she is currently at Children's Hospital, and like Nina said, you're going to wave to the camera, so if you want to wave again, you can. Hey, Sil. On January 1st, Priscilla tested positive for flu and pneumonia, and to keep her as safe as possible, her team has decided to keep her admitted while she finishes this round of radiation treatment. In classic Priscilla fashion, no matter what, she was strong enough to continue her treatment. As you all know, we're here today to honor Priscilla, a former 3-sport varsity athlete, an MTOE Ducks alumni, and an all-around great person. Priscilla's life took a turn in July of 2021 when she is diagnosed with glioblastoma, brain cancer. I stood here a year ago and spoke about the grace she has shown in the face of adversity. A year later, I can confirm that she is still full of the utmost grace and the most empowering strength. I would be lying to you if I said that it was a year filled with smooth sailing. There have been hard days, hard noons, and frustrating moments. But to me, that is not what has stuck out over the last year. And I know for Priscilla, it is the same. A lesson, an amount of teaching given at one time, a period of learning or teaching. There have been so many lessons this year. Lesson one, we have learned to celebrate any victory, no matter how small. Every victory is a reminder that progress can be made. Good things can still happen. As an athlete, Priscilla knows of victory and defeat, and throughout this time, I have seen her, the people around her, and her medical team celebrate the small victories. It allows us to savor the good moments and bask in the things that we can control. Lesson two, when a door closes, find a window. Things haven't always gone as planned in these last 2 years for Priscilla. Doors have closed on her, doors she worked really hard to open for herself. But the window she has found is a way to keep fighting and a way to stay true to herself. Priscilla still cracks the best jokes, will 100% of the time tell you the raw, honest truth, and will be the most supportive friend you have. She truly has a never quit attitude, and I can say that firsthand, she's the strongest, most tenacious person I have ever met. Lesson three, life is what you make it. While Priscilla can sit here and point out all the things that have gone wrong and give up, she doesn't. She wakes up every day, she does her treatment, and she never complains. She's found a way to make this year still have some semblance of joy in the least joyous of times. A blessing, God's favor and protection. Along with the lessons we have all learned this year, there have been plenty of blessings. Blessing one, sometimes when life derails your path, the pit stops along the way are things you never would have seen otherwise. Priscilla has gotten to travel so much this year. She's got to go on a 2-week-long religious pilgrimage to France and Italy with the beautiful Mother Olga and her incredible family. She's gotten to go to Cincinnati and be on ESPN for the basketball tournament with our new incredible friends, the Griffith family, and their sideline cancer organization. The Bonicas also joined their cousins on a trip to Washington, D.C., where they took in all the monuments, something Priscilla has always wanted to do with her dad. Priscilla spent a week at the unbelievable Tommy's Place in Falmouth, surrounded by her close family and friends. A postcard type of year, if you ask me. Blessing two, family and friends. I don't think there's a better support system in this world than the one Priscilla has. If you just look around the gym right now, from her family to her friends, to sideline cancer, to her MTOE Ducks family, to the Quincy community, Priscilla's name and story has reached far and wide. There's even a fight in Children's Hospital amongst the nurses as to who gets to have her on their shift. And as someone so close to Priscilla, all I can ever want for her is to be loved and supported the way she is. Blessing three, love and kindness. Before this happened, I didn't know that love and kindness like this existed in the world. I didn't know people could be so generous and selfless. Priscilla has felt more love over the past year than she thought was possible. And isn't that such a blessing and such a gift to truly know how much you've touched people? So as we anxiously wait to see what the next year has in store, what we can do is count our lessons and blessings. We can look for new ones, we can pray for a cure for this terrible illness, pray for Priscilla's continued strength, especially when the clock strikes 8 p.m. We can soak in all the good moments, because as Priscilla taught me, let it be and don't sweat the small stuff. I can't thank you all enough for loving and supporting Priscilla the way you have, and I know that Erin, Steve, Adam, and Natalie feel the same. As I am writing this, I realize there are no words in any language that can truly convey the love and respect I have for Priscilla. This event, this turnout, and this amount of support confirms that no one does. Priscilla is a once-in-a-lifetime friend, a one-in-a-million person, and a special soul. So while we continue to hope and pray for her, let's try and live life every day a little bit more like her, soaking in all of our lessons and blessings. Thank you.
Let's give it one more time now. And with that, is the lineup for Fontbonne Academy. At guard, a junior from Quincy, number 15, Ava Donahue. At the other guard, a senior from Walmart, number 3, Colleen Fogarty. At guard, a sophomore from Rockland, number 21, Jessica LaFon. A forward for Norwood, junior number 33, Tressa Murphy. And at center, a junior from Hanover, number 10, Lily Lowe. Fontbonne is coached by Claire Murphy. And now, if you want to make some noise from your Quincy freshmen. Starting at guard, this girl is a senior captain, number 21.
Yeah. Thank you.
Jessica Laplan Corbury.
Alyssa Hawks on the line for Quincy.
On stage, small park basketball.
six, five, four, three, two, one.
Thank you.
7.
Oh!
Ball from Quincy, Sabrina Walton. It's her first team score.
Thank you.
Caroline Tracy.
Thank you. Also, there are crosses with prayer messages on them specific to Priscilla to commemorate 8 p.m. So if you would like one, her sister Marilyn's around and she's handing them up. Thank you.
Quincy basketball.
Shoot one and one.
Pauline Fogarty. Let's give it to the 14s. They don't play great. All 14s gave us a great watch.